Now, in 2009, just to conclude the story, in a much lesser way, I also did what I'd not known to do before. And I stood down after 20 years in Parliament and many years leading the opposition. And a few months later, I had an approach from one of Mandela's successors, the president of the day, Jacob Zuma, who offered me an appointment to become a South African ambassador in South America, in Argentina. And here was my chance to do what I'd never done before, not to represent a party, but a country in another country across the South Atlantic, having absorbed the lessons that sometimes you put country before party. And in my preparation for this exciting and exacting task in Latin America, I went and reread the classic novels of the South American literary giant Gabriel Garcia Marquez. And you know, he spoke about the miracle and wonders, magical realism. And as I read them, I realized there was something truly miraculous and wondrous of what we'd done here on the southern tip of Africa more than two decades ago. But like any national story, it needs to be renewed and refreshed so that we are not simply remembered for the one big thing we got right as a golden historic footnote, not having addressed the many things that have gone wrong since then. And the way to address them is not to succumb to the sclerosis of power, of corruption, and simply of lethargy. We must reimagine the future and refresh it again with hope and courage. And with purposeful renewal does come the reality of hope. Gabriel Garcia Marquez, who died in April this year, said, "It is not true that people stop pursuing dreams when they grow old. They grow old when they stop pursuing dreams." Thank you.